to all traders and welcome to another edition of today's Stockwatch video. So today I'll be looking at US indices after they've capped off quite a magnificent turnaround since last week. And we'll look at the chart shortly, but they're actually on a four-day winning streak currently with the S&P and the Dow Jones particularly pushing higher. So let's look at some of the figures then. The Dow Jones rose just over 300 points or just under 1%, and the S&P gained 1.9% on yesterday's trading session. So the big jumps in the market saw Tesla jump 8% as reported yesterday on the Stockwatch video after it's negotiating with its investors a potential stock split when their annual general meeting happens in October, and that pushed the stock 8% higher, one of the biggest performers on the S&P, and that's why we saw such a high momentum in the indice yesterday. And we saw Dow. Also, we saw Apple in the Dow actually having quite a momentous 12-day winning streak at the moment, as we're looking now at its longest winning streak since 2003. So that could be quite pivotal in another push and a hold above the 35,000 handle for the Dow as we get into the trading session as well. NFP numbers coming up on Friday, don't forget. So this can actually give another push to the American economy as well. Looking at the Dow Jones, S&P and Nasdaq in particular, and also don't forget the US index, which is peaking just below the $100 mark, which is quite significant. Haven't seen these measures and levels for quite a while for the US index, so we'll see how that really starts moving and shaking the market as well. Just another small note that Apple's market cap is just creeping under $3 trillion, so quite significant there, as they did want to get to that stage at the back end of 2021, but now it looks like they are actually achieving that height as well. With Russia and Ukraine tensions simmering, we're seeing a little bit more of traders moving to these US indices as well. Excuse me. So let's just take a look at the charts as we go into Wednesday's session. So as you can see here, Dow Jones really capping off a four-day winning streak. The open hasn't been as fortuitous, but I've just been looking at the RSI signals here. We could be in for a small bearish divergence if the prices don't really move any higher, and the RSI is now actually falling as well. So we could see in the near term a possible move to the downside, maybe a bounce off this Ichimoku top border area and then another push higher. It's imperative that the Dow holds above 35,000, otherwise we could see another sink, and you know, as we've seen in previous sessions not so long ago, earlier in the month, these 33 and 34,000 mark in that respect. So just keep an eye out for that in that respect. And looking on the 4-hour chart, looking a little bit more clearer, I'll just move the drawings for you. So trading well above the Ichimoku cloud on the intraday chart, and you know, bias is on the upside. We're just waiting now to see if this particular candle here is going to start being kind of like an engulfing one and start moving downwards to this border here. We could see penetration below the 35,000 handle today, but we'll see in the near term as well. As I said, another bearish divergence on the RSI in the near term, but how much will this weigh on these prices? So just keep an eye out for that as well. S&P on the other hand, just want to show you on the daily chart the momentous upsurge and this gap in the market that we saw in the open of yesterday's session. And this was due to Tesla having quite a pivotal say in prices. So whenever there is a big move in the stock market, just look on the indices as well, because this can be heavily affected, as we've seen yesterday. And we've got other big players in the indices such as Facebook, Apple, Amazon. They all pushed higher yesterday as well. We've got Chevron and ExxonMobil having quite a good month so far. And as we cap off Q1 going into Q2, we'll see more momentous moves due to earnings season as well. So just keep an eye out for that coming up in the next few weeks. Keep an eye on your earnings season calendar as well. On the 4-hour chart, it's looking pretty bid for the S&P. Prices are looking to start moving higher. We're trading very far away from the Ichimoku cloud, which is a good indication that prices will keep moving to the upside. So I'll be putting some bids in there later in the session. And obviously, we are looking at an overbought scenario here, but not as overbought as it could have been. We're looking at this just over the 70 mark. It can actually push up to the 100 mark on the RSI. So keep that in mind as well. If you are looking for signals on these momentum indicators, it can actually lead to good signals and obviously good opportunities as well. So that's all from today's video. Keep an eye out, as I said, for the NFP numbers coming up on Friday, and we'll speak again soon. Bye for now.